I would have treated Jean-Claude Laval exactly the way you did. The procedures
Daddy,
you described.
Dad, Chelsea does not care about the procedures. She thinks the guy should not have died, period.
A practice suit would do to Dr. Bauer.
No, whatever it does, it won't make up for Jean-Claude's death now, will it?
It'll compensate John. Just leave me wanting you to stay over.
Oh, wait a minute. Now, you're worried about the mirror. Okay, well, Dad, how's it going to look if a byline by the publisher's son appears in the journal instead?
This stuff on the Spaulding Enterprise is all right, but I think it needs some help. I think I can fix it, though.
Long enough to hear you say something about a little trick, huh? Are you back on the illegal act story again?
What'd you do with the original?
I destroyed it.
Did Phillip find out?
Yeah, he caught me red-handed.
It's gone too far. I can't just quit and run away and hide because of some possible unforeseen danger lurking out there.
What do you want? We'd better talk inside.
Chelsea, what a nice surprise. Come on in.
I can't stay long. I'm off to Alan Spaulding's for Christmas Eve dinner.
Philip. Heard some very interesting things about you. Well, if you're talking about our art dealings, don't forget you are equally incriminated.
I have no idea, but I do know that I'm about to sit down.
No, sit together. Come on, I want to cover you both.
I'm tired of being second best. Everything I touch belongs to Beth, including you. I guess it's time I let her have you.
I am going to cut him out of Spaulding Enterprises. And in so doing, I am going to cut off his power.
Just when I do this, tonight in front of everyone,
Mary.
Oh. Let me in!
Oh, sorry, Chelsea. Think you're gonna have to miss the gala.
Oh, don't do this to me!
Glad to see you made it. What'd you think?
Of One-on-One with Johnny Bauer here on WSPR.
You and Johnny did such a great job.
Thank you, Lainey.
No kidding.
Sorry, I'm late.
Who's that?
Ray Rooney. She was Chelsea's roommate in New York. She's just moved to Springfield. Johnny?
What is it?
A little gift from your devoted fan.
Look, I know what kind of person this fan is. And believe me, it's someone we don't know.
Tell me what you want. Stop it! Stop it! Tell me what
you... Okay.
You know what? You look great. Chelsea, you want to live with me?
Yes. You did this to me. You did this to me, and you're gonna pay. I knew it was you. You're the fan. You're crazy, Danny. You know that?
Thank you.
need to know everything about Phillip and I.
Oh, I don't feel I need to know. It's just...
You're curious?
Why do you care?
Can't you let him go?
I don't trust you, Mike. It's
not good enough.
Well, it's good enough for me. Besides, you're what a lot of people I care about.
Still have a yen for Phillip, huh?
Rick, Ed, Meredith, should I go on?
And you're afraid for John. Well, I guess any daughter of Roger Thorpe's is dangerous to any Bauer.
Well, you can blame it on heredity if you'd like, but you've done enough all by yourself to make anyone distressed you.
And I have to answer to you, of course.
Oh, absolutely not.
That's true.
Johnny isn't over Roxy, and I'm not going to make the same mistake again.
Chelsea, Johnny is not Phillip.
I know that. But I've done that before. Falling in love with a guy is in love with a ghost. And I'm telling you, Rick, it doesn't work.
It's not the same.
Maybe not. Beth was really dead, but Roxy...
You know, calling her at my apartment when you know she's with me is inconsiderate. But then to hang up like some little adolescent schoolboy. What, are you stupid? Did you think she wouldn't tell me?
No, really.
Oh, come on, Phillip. Do you really think that Johnny would do something like that? I mean, why, because Chelsea. He's afraid of you or something?
No.
Maybe your girl wasn't nervous.
Stop, Chelsea. Yeah, I thought so. I guess he fooled you, too.
Well, Phillip, it has happened before, but the man involved was a bigger skunk.
Chelsea, when are you going to get a new bathroom?
Come on, Phil. That's a cheap shot. Besides, I kind of like it.
Oh, you two are just too cute for words.
If you just stay.
Mr. Spaulding, are you suggesting that I spend the night with you?
Just trying to be thoughtful.
I'll be right back.
Where are you going?
Oh, I just happen to have an overnight bag in the car.
Be quiet.
But she left.
It's the law.
Well, you know me, I always respect the law.
Mm.
If I'm not mistaken, dust is clearing everywhere. Memories awaken, my feet on the runway. It's a beautiful day. I look to the sky now. I'm finding my way. I'm flying.
Gave you the right to invade his privacy.
I'm a reporter.
Being a reporter gave you the right to grill Adam Thorpe about his dead son.
Being a reporter makes it my job to find out the truth, Holly.
Well, then let me tell you something. Your job investigating the life and times of Roger Thorpe is now over.
Well, my boss says otherwise.
I am your boss, remember?
Fletcher and the Journal have seniority, Holly.
Then you better decide who it is you're working for, him or me.
Well, I'm just going to have to think about that one.
Doubt on my little sister. This may not be a very liberated stance, but it is my feeling that when the guy walks out, you get to rake him over the coals, whether he was lousy or if he was great.
Hey, I like that.
Hey, take this, you bum! Yeah, and since you've been gone, I can